The climate community is this enormous potential movement, but it's like the difference between an incandescent light bulb and a laser. We're the dim bulbs because our light is going every which direction. We're not well organized, and we're certainly not well organized for power. As of our last national study in December, 26% of Americans are what we call alarmed. These are people who are firmly convinced it's happening, it's human caused, it's urgent, and they strongly, strongly support action, and they want to know what can they do to get involved.
How many of those alarmed Americans are so alarmed that they would be willing to engage in, say, nonviolent civil disobedience to stop climate change from getting worse?
About 6.6 million people in this country say that they would definitely do so if they were asked. Even more Americans, about 20 million Americans who are alarmed, are willing to get engaged in advocating for action by their elected officials. The climate community is sitting on this enormous potential political movement, but it has to be organized. So just to put this in contrast, think of the NRA as a perfect case in point. They've had enormous political influence. We're a country of over 300 million people. How many people are actually members of the NRA? It's about 4 million. They punch way above their weight numerically because they're organized. And that's the key difference I want to distinguish here, is that the climate community is this enormous potential movement, but it's like the difference between an incandescent light bulb and a laser.
So Tony, what can activists do to make this movement more effective?
So I think at least one of the things that has been sorely missing is what we would call transformational organizing. So much organization up to this point has been what is called transactional. You can think of this as a big green group that basically has a million members, and they ask their members every once in a while, send me a check, and that'll pay for us as professionals to go do this lobbying on your behalf. Important work, not denying that at all. But that's different than transformational organizing, which is really an organization that has at the core of its DNA recruiting, training, and then deploying advocates to be advocates at every level to the political and, frankly, the corporate system, putting pressure on companies to change their behavior. You've seen new groups like the Sunrise Movement, for example, that has begun to organize around this idea. A totally different group, Citizens Climate Lobby, has essentially organized this way.
That's what transformational means in this context, that you're growing the grassroots presence base of this movement.
That's right. You're empowering people to become active citizens, not just a source of money.
I want to turn to some other findings of your research. We know that climate scientists overwhelmingly agree that fossil fuels cause climate change. But how many Americans understand how overwhelming the consensus is among climate scientists?
Unfortunately, it's only about 20% of Americans who understand that more than 9 out of 10 climate scientists are convinced that human-caused global warming is happening. And what we know is that because many people have this misperception that the experts are still arguing about the reality of the problem, not realizing that, of course, the scientific community did that literally decades ago. When people understand that the experts agree, they then themselves say, well, then I think it's real. And that in turn makes them more worried about it. And that in turn makes them more supportive of policy action.
As we know, something like 8 million, maybe more people a year die from fossil fuel pollution, not climate change, but the pollution that comes from fossil fuels. How many Americans understand that there are that many fatalities resulting from fossil fuel emissions?
What we see very clearly is that most people don't have any idea. Like when we ask them, how many people do you think die every year because of climate change? Most people will say, you know, a few dozen, maybe around the world. They're off by orders of magnitude. And so what this really comes back to is that for most people, climate change is in one part of their brain and health issues are in a different part of the brain. And nobody's ever connected those dots. Nobody's ever helped them understand how climate change affects heat wave risk, which kills more people in this country than any other climate impact. How it affects the air that we're breathing and asthma attacks. So the point is that there are lots of different connections people can make to the health angle, and you just need to find the right one. One of the first rules of effective communication is know your audience, so you can meet them where they are, not where you are.